In today's news, the cash flow killer. No fewer than 12 electrical contracting firms go to the wall in a black month for the trade. Sparks call out the TV soap Emmerdale after a character becomes an electrician in just 6 weeks. And we reveal a clever solution to the problem of EV cables crossing the pavement. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Schneider Electric. Whether you're listening in the van, on site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And as always, if you think you've spotted the two words I've been challenged to slip into today's show, comment them below for the chance to win a prize. It's been a devastating month in the electrical trade, with no fewer than a dozen prominent contractors going into administration. Victims of the tough economic headwinds include Aberla M&E Limited, CEI Electrical Limited, Customised Electrical Services Limited, NWP Electrical and Mechanical Limited, K&F Contracting Limited, and NSR Engineering Limited in Ireland. Experts say that one underlying cause is that electrical contractors arrive on site in the later stages in the progress of a project, when delays and cancellations are more likely. Some electrical contractors are trying to fulfil tenders they put in before big price rises in copper cables, steel trunking, labour and insurance. This puts their margins under huge pressure. Also on the rise are snagging claims which can wipe out profits. Finally, reports say that payment terms are starting to drift again, leading to a perfect storm for the trade. Amos Simbo, chief of M&E firm Winway Consultants, said that, as ever, cash flow is the biggest killer. That was illustrated when NSR Engineering Limited went bust with the loss of 50 jobs. The company was £675,000 in the red, despite having valuable contracts worth over £13 million. In other news, the electrical installation industry has got together to call on the government to tackle the cost of living crisis by immediately changing the way electricity and gas are taxed. The ECA, BSER, BSRIA, Select and other organisations and bodies have sent an open letter to Rishi Sunak and Liz Truss. They are urging the next Prime Minister to shift the taxes from electricity to gas. The open letter marks the launch of ECA's new campaign. It's called Make the Switch, and it's designed to make Britain's energy bills fairer for households. Currently, electricity is four times more expensive than gas. It says that by changing the way different energy sources are levied, 70% of households could immediately save up to £100 a year, and the UK could cut their imports of gas. With one small act, the next government could throw a lifeline to millions of struggling families desperately worried by the prospect of rising energy price caps. In product news this week, a range of integrated PV panels which look like roof slates have been unveiled by Goodwe. They come in three flavours. The Sunshine series is an easy to install 92 watt panel, offering 170 watts per square metre. This makes it ideal for homes, hotels and community and public buildings. The Polaris is a lightweight panel which can be used in carports and flat or sloped roof conversions. They generate 184 watts per square metre. The Starlux, meanwhile, is designed for conservatories because it provides both shade and energy generation. Now, have you ever tripped on an EV cable running across a pavement? Even with a really well-installed cable protector, which is not how you'd describe the one you can see on screen right now, they pose a significant trip hazard to the elderly, the partially sighted, and late-night pubgoers. Now, a firm owned by Oxford City Council has proposed a solution. It suggests a simple channel chased into the pavement. The first local authority to allow its pavements to be cut is Bedfordshire. It's set up a trial to see if the idea works. Electrical car owners are being invited to take part in the scheme if they don't have off-street parking. Backers of the channel say it seamlessly integrates into the pavement and the cables won't cause an obstacle. Bedfordshire will fund 20 installations, and if the scheme is given the green light, fees will be introduced for the rest of the electrical car owners who want one. Experts say it could be a big step to solving the problem of EV charging in cities. Staying with EV news for a moment, Schneider Electric has announced the launch of EV Link Pro AC for commercial and residential buildings. As building owners and house builders continue to navigate changing regulations, the connected EV charging station is designed specifically for buildings and makes installation simpler while offering superior flexibility and reliability for residents living in multifamily homes. Following the recent high-profile electrocutions, which we've covered in our news weeklies, UK Power Networks has developed a special training device which it thinks could help. The DigSafe is a learning tool designed to reduce accidents where builders come into contact with electric cables. In training sessions, when a shovel hits an exposed muck cable, there's an almighty bang and it lights up to mimic a realistic cable strike.
Thank you.
The shovel used has previously been in a real-life strike. The idea behind the unusual device is to prompt conversations about safety and make it feel real. It's part of a set which can also be converted to show similar dangers around overhead cables. The building trade was involved in the highest number of cable damage incidents in the past year. In our eFIXX survey this week, we asked you how long you take on your tea break, and some early results are coming in. A mere 13% of you take 5 to 10 minutes, a quarter take 10 to 15 minutes, a fifth of you take a leisurely 20 minutes, and 12% replied that they work for the council. So what does that mean then, like a permanent tea break? And a whopping 35% of you asked what on earth is a tea break. Folks, you need to learn to make time for yourselves and your mental health. After all, time flies like an arrow, and fruit flies like a banana. In fact, we're testing some kit that could really help with tea breaks. On our YouTube channel this week, we're pitting Makita's latest battery-powered kettle against the Builder's Tea Box from BTB Products. So, if you like a brew, and after all, who doesn't, make sure you catch that video to find out if Gary would rather use the Makita kettle to make a hot drink or suck on a soggy loofah instead. And finally, electricians have reacted with fury after Noah Dingle, the soap opera character in long-running series Emmerdale, emerged from a six-week stay in prison as a fully qualified electrician. The teenage tearaway, who's been on the show since his birth in 2004, was sentenced to 3 months in prison for stalking and harassing his on-screen ex-girlfriend, Chloe Harris. Initially trying to escape justice, Noah soon faced up to his crimes, but was stunned to be sent to jail for what he did. On leaving prison early, Noah boasted about his new technical qualifications while looking for work, but professional electricians have poured scorn on the storyline, alleging that the writers are out of touch. One wrote, "You can't become a qualified electrician after a few weeks in prison." We certainly look forward to seeing Noah's electrical work in future Emmerdale episodes, and seeing as the series is filmed not a million miles away from our Skipton studio, we hereby invite him to take on the eFIXX challenge wall. I wonder where he'd finish on the board. Now, if you think you know the words that I've smuggled into today's show, pop your guess into the comments and we'll dig out a goodie bag prize to the first to get the right answers. Last week's words were skedaddle and pneumatic, and only one person guessed it right. That was point forward. So well done to you, and please click the link in the show notes to claim your prize. Coming up this week, we've got a Q&A on how to measure light levels, and if you missed it last week, get caught up on our live stream with special guests both in the studio and on the challenge wall, including an attempt by the MD of Luden Palazzoli that will quite simply blow your mind. If you're watching on YouTube, you can access it right here. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Schneider Electric. Make sure you're subscribed to receive the next update. And until next time, have a great week, stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.